Beau Crable here, leading expert for selling products on Amazon. And in this video, I want to talk about, again, passive income. So I want to start off explaining, first off, what is passive income?
Got wisdom way beyond his years.
Real deal.
He's like a prodigy.
You can look up a definition. My definition is that when I go to bed at night, when I sleep, or if I just do nothing, that I just go hang out for a full week, a full month, or if I get hit by a bus today and can't do anything, the money that I'm making, that is profit, that is coming in from wherever, is my passive income. Now, my passive income breaks down through my investments, some of it's business income, some of it's consulting, some of it's royalties. I'll talk about that later. But some people believe that passive income is actually not a real thing. No idea why. If you believe that, you probably are really bad at working smart. So now what I want to talk about is my passive income and how it's broken down. So around 40% of my income is actually through my investments. Over this past year, I've just tripled down on educating myself as an investor. The reasons why is I'm young, and understanding how investments grow. Now, maybe someday my business might not be my main source of income. If you would ask me 2 years ago, year and a half ago, closer to 90% of my income was off of my business. Now, I mean, I'm actually making more of my business and 40% is off my investments because I've gotten so much smarter as an investor. And then the other 60% is off my business. Now, so let me talk about investing right now. There's some things I can't talk about for privacy issues on where some of my investments are, but I believe that staying to your core and understanding what, like the knowledge that you do know, invest there. Only invest in the things that you know. The great Warren Buffett says he's a better investor because he's a businessman, and a better businessman because he's an investor, and I believe that to the core. So a lot of my investment passive income comes from is off of owning other companies or owning equity into them. There's a couple companies I can't talk about, but another like set of companies that I do own in my portfolio is wholesale companies. Why do I decide to buy up wholesale companies? Well, because my main business, selling on Amazon, is selling products, and I buy from wholesale companies. So if I'm gonna continue to be a, not necessarily a consumer, but a user, an investor already into these wholesale companies, it might make sense for me to go get some equity into them. Make kind of double dip right there. There's that. I also have consulted for retail stores and other e-commerce stores who want to up their game in e-commerce or online. And I sold my time for money there, but then I also was smart enough because I wanted passive income going on, is I got some royalties out of them. So there's some companies that I have royalties from. And also a part of on the investment side is the stock market. So the stock market's a very broad thing. I was very lucky enough, again, super lucky, this is not gonna happen for most people, to live with a mentor of mine who spoken to over a million people on invest in the stock market, and all he does is trade the financial markets. So I learned a lot from there. I don't have any cryptocurrency. I have real estate. For me, I don't even think real estate's that smart for me to get into, just because I can make a lot more money in my e-commerce businesses and the stock market, and spending more time on consulting for retail stores and e-commerce and just growing up my e-commerce businesses. But I do have some real estate. I've bought at a good price. I might sell soon because it's okay, but none of that's really been income. I guess there's been capital gains that added to net worth. So when people like consider capital gains as their passive income, I don't count income until it's cash in your account, which then you want to get that cash out as soon as possible to then put in other assets. So now let me talk about my business. So what people get confused at with passive income is they think that running a business is passive income. I'm sorry, but yeah, that's probably quite backwards you can think. Now, there are certain aspects to my business that is 100% passive because I've hired the right people and have super trust with them that, you know what, yeah, I could get hit by a bus today and could not run my business, be totally fine. There's been times I've just like, you know what, I'm gonna take a week off and just do nothing on this business because I have other things going on. My products business is where I'm selling products online on marketplaces like Amazon, eBay. We also sell on our own site. I also have a software business where I'm selling the software that I use myself. I have an education business where we're selling training programs and courses and working with people one-on-one on that end, speaking at events, all that jazz. I love doing what I do, but some of that stuff is not purely passive, and some is just based off of where I've outsourced so much. And around 60% of my income does come from there. And that's really about it. So if you're wanting to get into passive income, and the reason's why is because you're like, okay, I need to change my financial aspect. Don't think that you running a business is gonna be passive overnight. Because one thing, just be super cautious of, I want you to never use this phrase ever again that people love to use, advertisers use it to get you hooked, is never say, I want to replace my income. As an investor, that's the most idiotic thing I could ever hear. If you're making an income, why would you want to get that replaced? Now, I get it. If you get offered a better job, whatever, cool. But if you having a job and thinking you running a business is going to replace your income, that is so, so not smart, uneducated. And as an investor, that's only going to cause disrupted and out of place investments. Because as an investor, you want to not be disrupted in your investments. You want to just keep growing, 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 growing. That's why me being young, I've spent so much time in the past year educating myself as an investor, because if I look in 40, 50 years from now, if I get uninterrupted gains, it's massive, right? So instead, think on how can I increase my income, put into investments that are giving me cash flow that is greater than my expenses, so I can then go full depth into my business. Don't say, how can I sell products on Amazon to replace my income? That's idiotic. If you hear people saying that to you, they're just trying to steal like some money from you. Not steal, but like whatever. So in reality, what you should be thinking is, how can I grow my assets, my investment income, passive income, so where it now exceeds my income. So now whatever income that you were getting that you want to replace is now a waste of your time. You want to get your time to be worth more. I give this maybe a complicated video, but to recap this, passive income is income where if you are dead, sleeping, doing nothing, income's coming in. Don't get running a business confused with passive income. It's not the same. You can outsource and delegate to make it passive, like what I'm doing. Educate yourself as an investor. Go after it. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. If you have any questions at all, I'm open to any type of comments. Negative feedback haters, I'm welcome to you as well. Subscribe to this YouTube channel. Turn the little bell to get notified for my videos. Follow me on social media and have a great day.